Since 1979, over 120,000 children from China have been internationally adopted, and most of them were girls. 44-year-old twins, Tanya and Kim, are hoping to discover their origins after they were left at an orphanage in neighbouring Hong Kong. With no information about their parents, they're now hoping DNA will help them discover the truth about their adoption.
Hello!
Hi!
How are you? Really lovely to meet you. Thank you so much for your time. This is your home, right?
Yes.
Really, really nice place. Quite fancy. I'm waiting to get kicked out.
Yeah.
Why don't we start from the very top? Can you talk me through what it is that you're trying to find out?
Growing up, me and my sister, we were told pretty early on that we were adopted because it's kind of obvious. Our parents were British Caucasian. And it's one of those questions that's always been there in the back of my mind is, you know, who am I and where do I come from?
What do you think your story is?
In Hong Kong, at the time we were adopted, was democratic. It belonged to the United Kingdom. And so we don't know the circumstances around why we were given up. Perhaps we had been born in China.
Solving this mystery is more pressing than ever, as Tanya has been diagnosed with terminal bowel cancer.
This is one of those big things in my life that I wanted to get done before I die. We were 3 years old when we were adopted. The story that we tell people is that we were born in China to the one-child policy. I'd like to know if it's the truth.
I think the reason that Tanya pursued this is because the question of mortality is before her. I think there's definitely a sense of urgency now, and she doesn't want to leave any loose ends.
Tanya's health has severely deteriorated. She's been moved to a hospice for end-of-life care. Her twin sister Kim will be staying with her.
When we're young, we always think that we're invincible. And we always think we've got tomorrow. There's always time. And what we don't realize is time is literally the only currency that you can't get back. It's the only currency of value.
At Tanya's request, Turi has come to see her at the hospice to give her any information she's managed to find.
Hello again.
Hello, it's lovely to see you again.
So good to see you.
So I know when you first came to us, you wanted to see if DNA could help you because you were adopted and you really didn't know much about your early life. And we got some really interesting results. What we found was that overwhelmingly, you are getting matches in China. About 80% of your ancestry is coming from southern China.
Oh.
Yeah. And then you're also getting quite a concentration around Guangzhou. So just north of Hong Kong.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
We were just north of Hong Kong.
We've got more.
There's more? They got more, Tanya.
So we have an intermediary, and she did some extraordinary work and contacted the adoption agency in Hong Kong. They were able to provide quite a lot of information. One of the questions that you had was, had you been dropped in Hong Kong because your parents were from northern China and this was a time of the one-child rule? That wasn't the case. They were from Hong Kong. And they were really young. Oh. They were in their mid-teens.
Oh, my God.
And they didn't feel that they could look after you.
Of course. They hadn't even finished being children themselves.
Exactly. Is it true you've not ever seen a picture of yourself as a baby? This is a picture of you.
Oh my God! You're all like that. Oh my God!
Isn't it gorgeous?
No.
Gosh. Isn't she beautiful? Look at that face. Yeah.
Him. Wasn't it fun to just dance over to you? Does that make you feel better to know that? Are they still alive?
That we don't know. The adoption agency is doing further work.
God, they're not even in their 70s yet, Tanya. That's how young they were. They were given an opportunity to follow this up. Yeah, I will. You're not alone. Had parents that cared. Did. Yeah. They made a hard choice to give us more. We've always assumed that we were abandoned. Mm. So I think it changes how we perceive our parents.
Absolutely.
You know?
Yeah, of course.
To know that that's a huge sacrifice as a parent to make.
Oh,
to give your child up like that. Just two of them. I hope that I can find them just to let them know that their kids had a better life. You know? And that the choice that they made was the right choice. I definitely believe.
I'm so pleased they were able to do this for you.
Thank you so much.
Oh, you're absolutely welcome.
Thank you. And you had big ears.
I think the things that shape you as a person are the people that you meet and the things that happen to you along the way. I have to be grateful, I have to be thankful, I have to remember who got me here and how I got here. I've been very lucky in my life.
A week after receiving her DNA results, Tanya passed away with her sister by her side.
This is most definitely a beginning. It's opened a door. And I really hope, you know, that I continue to pick up that baton from Tanya and move forward with it. I want to find them because I want to be able to give them the answer that it was the right choice. Hey, we turned out okay. And we did more than okay. We did great, you know? And I hope that, you know, even though they never knew us, that they can be proud of us.